Hi guys, a very very good morning to you. This is Anjali Tarot and this is a general love reading for all the Aries Sun, Moon, Venus rising. Keep in mind this is general, it might or might not resonate with you at the first place. And the second thing, the roles can be reversed anytime. And this is a reading from 11th of October till the 21st of October, okay? We will take it 10 days. Cool, let's start. Aries, your partner's current energy right now is, I'm using these cards now and I'm using the Light Shears Tarot. I love these cards. So this is Light Shears and this is the Rider Waite that I always use. So let's see how the reading is coming for you guys. Let me wear my bracelet quickly. Yeah, okay. So your partner's current energy right now is, I think I should do it with this one. Your partner's current energy right now is Aries. Let me see. I just bought this deck and cleanse it. Now I'm doing the first reading for you guys. Aries, your partner's current energy right now is, let's see, the Emperor. Aries, this is your energy actually. The Emperor is the Aries, okay, itself. So right now I feel like your partner is might be taking a decision or they are acting very very rude or cold or detached, but I feel like this person has taken certain kind of decision in their life and they are sticking to that. This is the current situation. They are trying to take a decision. If not, they have not taken the decision. They are trying their best to take a decision in their life and then stick to that. So the Emperor energy is basically the energy of sticking to a decision and not giving a shit to the other person or other, you know, person involved in a particular situation. Let me clarify what kind of decision they are taking. Let me see. Let's clarify the Emperor. Five of Pentacles, this is the Five of Swords, lots of five, and the Wheel of Fortune, okay. I feel like this person right now is trying their best to walk away from a certain situation or from a certain, you know, person in their life. They are taking a decision that they will walk away because they are feeling betrayed, backstabbed. They are feeling something bad happened to them or somebody just did something really wrong with them. So they are trying to take this decision, making this decision. And I feel like this person is right now acting very very, you know, rude. You can say it is kind of ego battle going on with them or with them and you or with the them or somebody else, or there's some kind of, you know, ego battle going on and they just want to resolve this ego battle and they want the universe to intervene between them and this person who is dealing with them, particularly who is having an ego clash with them, and they just want the universe to intervene in this and do the, you know, healing, do the process and just handle the process. This is certain kind of decision and that is definitely related to somebody walking away from someone and they are trying their best to show that they don't give a shit, but actually I feel like from inside this person is right now very very weak and they're just trying their best to show that they are not weak at all and they are doing just fine in their life, okay. And they have taken the decision that universe will see. The universe will see whatever something happened in them, happened to them in the past regarding a love situation. They have taken the decision that the universe will see that particular person or that particular situation. Let's go with the flow. Okay, Aries, let's see what's your current energy. Eight of Swords. I feel like you are feeling in some kind of mental jail right now. This is your energy, Eight of Swords energy, okay? Can you see this lady trying their best to come out of a situation, but she is not able to do that, okay? It is like she is holding a mirror and she is not able to see the clear picture. She is trying her best to see the clear picture but not able to do that because her mind is playing games with her. This is the situation with you. Your mind is playing games with you. You are not able to come out of a certain situation or certain, you can say, thought that you have made for yourself. I feel like this is self-created fear, this is self-created mental jail that you have created for yourself, and you can come out of that situation but you are not able to do that because again there are mental games happening with you. Let me clarify the Eight of Swords in your current energy. Queen of Swords and Four of Wands and the Knight of Swords. Okay, you are feeling in mental jail because you want to have a committed and long-term relationship with somebody but you are not able to show it to them. Okay, you are trying your best to be very, very clear and honest with yourself, with them, with the other person, and all you want is a committed and solid relationship in your life, and you want it fast. You just want it just like that, just like that. Okay, you are not able to wait for the right time, or you are not able to, you know, just be patient enough to wait for the right time, or certain situation is there where you are feeling like you can't no longer wait for something to happen, and you just want to you just want things to be, you know, in a certain manner, like in a certain pattern, and you have fixed your mind that there. You're not able to, you know, what I'm trying to say is that you're not flexible enough to see the changing, okay? To see the changes actually. You have made your mind that this situation should be like this, and the commitment or marriage part should be like this, and this is a situation where I don't want to compromise, blah, blah, blah. This is the situation here. So your mind is playing games with you, and you are not able to come out of this situation at all. This is the situation here, Aries. Okay, let me see what this person feels for you, their feelings for you. Let me see what this person feels for you. Eight of Wands. This person feels like you guys should have a fast communication, back and forth communication, okay? They want to clear the air with you. Eight of Wands is clear picture where they want to have a communication and back and forth communication. Not just like, yeah, let's go on a date and just talk about shit. No, they just want to have a deep understanding, deep conversation with you. And this is a back and forth communication. They want to resolve the issues. They feel like they should have a communication with you. They feel like you should open up the gates of communication with them, so that you guys can, you know, connect each other on a level where you guys are on a maturity level and understand things on a deeper level, okay? Let me clarify the Eight of Wands as what they feel for you. Let me see. Five of Wands and the Two of Swords and the Ace of Pentacles. Definitely this person wants to, feels like, this person feels like they should have a conversation with you because they want to end the conflicts that you guys are facing.
Your next
each other.
Online time
you guys
is in
are
10
fighting
minutes.
With
please
each
come
other.
Online.
Really sorry.
Hi, your next online time is in 10 minutes. Please come online.
Yeah. So yeah, you guys had a certain conflict. You guys had a certain fight with each other. And this person and you both are on the crossroads. This person is feeling like you basically is on the crossroads and not able to decide on it. Or not able to take a decision. They on the other hand feel like they should have a communication with you. Open and honest and clear communication with you so that you guys can restart. Okay, they want to start this connection. They feel like these are their feelings for you, okay, for this particular connection with you or with you or for you. Okay, it could be you who is feeling like that. I told you the roles can be reversed anytime. Okay, so basically this person feels like you should end the conflict, you should end the crossroads situation, and both of you should have a brand new beginning. I feel like this person feels like you should give this connection a second chance. Not like just like lovers, but might be as a friend. Yeah, this is what they feel. Okay, let me see what this person wants from you, Aries. Okay, cool. Let me do this like this, okay, so that you guys can see. They want the King of Wands energy is here. This person wants the passion back, the fire back in this connection, and they feel like they want to take the risk of their life with you. They are just wearing their heart on his sleeves, okay? You can see the King of Wands is really a daring person, and they are really acting like a daring person right now, and they just want to take the risk of life. Risk of, you know, be in this connection with you again. This is what they want from you. They want you to be the King of Wands. They want you to take the risk of your life with them, or just not think about the future, just not think about the past. Just be passionate and just light up your fire for this connection again. This is what they want from you, okay? Let me clarify the King of Wands as what they want from you. Queen of Wands and the Three of Swords, my God, and the Three of Cups. Now I feel like this person wants you to leave the third party and have a reconciliation with them. First thing, If there is third party involvement here, this person just wants you to leave the third party party forever or clear the things with the third party forever, because they feel like deeply heartbroken without you, or they feel like deeply shattered without you. So they just want to clear the air with the third party and be with them. This is what they want from you, okay? Or if there is no third party here, you know better, right? Aries, you know. You know what is happening in their life and they know what is happening in your life. So if there is no third party involvement here, they just want to have a connection with you. Brand new beginning in the connection, and they just want to take the risk. This is the King of Wands. This is the Queen of Wands. This person wants to have the queen back in the relationship. Gender doesn't matter. It's like they want this pair to be with them again, okay? They want this pair to be, you know, with each other again, because they are deeply heartbroken and they want a reconciliation. This is the situation here, okay? I hope you're getting me. Cool. Let's see what is coming towards you till 11th of October. What is happening with you guys till 11th? Let's see. Three of Pentacles is here. I feel like you guys are going to work out for this. Can you see this person? This is teamwork, and they are making some kind of mat or something, and they are putting efforts, putting work on this energy. There are lots of three here, so for most of you, I feel like there's third party involvement here, and this third party is causing problems in this relationship a lot, and they want clarification from you that the third party is, you know, leaving, or you are leaving the third party, or something like that. And everything is going fine now, and you know, you guys are going to work out on the connection. This is what is happening here. So Three of Pentacles for me. For some of you, I feel like you are going to shift your focus completely on the work life, okay? For some of you, it is like the card is telling me that you guys are going to put in the effort, put in the energy, put in the work in this connection, okay? Both of you, not you only, both of you. The Lovers is here. The Six of Pentacles is here. The Ten of Pentacles is here. Can I tell you how many threes are here? Three. Three of Swords. Three of Cups. Three of Pentacles. The Lovers. Definitely a third party situation here. Definitely a third party situation here. And this third party is causing a very, very huge problem between you guys. Third party is always not a romantic connection with somebody else. It could be somebody else, like a mother-in-law, a mother, a father, a sister, somebody who is very close to you and creating problems in the relationship. Third party can be anybody. Third party is not always a romantic relationship with somebody else, okay? So what is coming towards you? I feel like for some of you who are ready to work in this connection, put in the effort, put in the energy in this connection, I feel like you guys are finally going to find a balance in the equation, and you guys are going to finally have the Ten of Pentacles energy. You guys are going to reconnect on a level where you guys are feeling very, very attracted towards each other. You guys are going to put in effort, put in energy in this connection. And then again, I feel like you guys are going to have a very, very beautiful energy of reconciliation, okay? And for some of you, if there is third party involvement here, I feel like you guys are going to find a way to come out of this third party situation, and again there's balance in the equation in this connection, and again there's happiness. Cool. This is a little complicated, I know, but try to understand what I'm saying, okay? So thank you so much, Aries, for listening to me. I'll see you soon in the next video. Bye bye. Take care. God bless you. Namaste.